Don Cartagena. Excuse my demeanor. Just the glamour life. You still not a player. You ain't half as nice. I'm born again. Life after death. I made the sacrifice. I'm super duper fly. Used to keep them hypnotized. I said my name is Juice. America's most. Ain't no half stepping. See you at the crossroads.
Money on my headstone. Here lies young. Getting paid for. Never take a loss on my headstone. Only take a ticket when I'm. Now your favorite rapper name on the headstone. Too late, you already did.
It was written in the children's story. Your life's a life's a. So what you want? Every day I struggle with it. Only God could judge me slipping. I'm infinitely big, big through the Genesis. Dead presidents, drop a gem on them. On earth, these the last days. Throw your get money, quiet storm. Have a thugs for the cream, renegade. For the money, only green is the green is the. I'm a player on the late night till. So the prototype, fingertips, reservoir dog, check the skull, ignorant, can I live, still filming, kiss to death, friend protect your neck, three boys in the Cadillac, grave digger, kiss to death, friend protect your neck, shame on the three boys in the Cadillac, grave digger,
money over on my headstone, here lies young, getting paid for, never take a loss on my headstone. Only take a ticket when I'm dead. I'm a gang three times on my headstone. Been from the cradle to the grave. Now your favorite rapper name on the headstone. Too late, you already did.
Right now I'm on the edge, so don't push me.
Trouble something 96.
You wish you could
breathe easy, know the ledge.
I'm your
what's that?
I smell.
Let me count my. I'm 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, run. Hi, my name is Dirk Cobain. Like a, here I go to the next episode. Ain't a near this explosive beast coast.
The mother, ride or die for my, strictly for my, survival of the fittest.
That's the sound of the police. I'm in deep cover, skirt, lean back. One more chance, they say Jesus folks and the devil wear Prada, but I'm so deaf, God can't tell me nothing, right, this on my death certificate, I gave you power, 21 questions, like, who the warning, watch them flashing like paparazzi, two words, get money, tonight's the night, guess who's back on my block, rather you need me, in Bucktown, this on that quiet storm, C-O-N-Y, top of New York, with a pitchfork.
Have an all white ring. Couldn't hit if it had ain't. Lanes can't call and you lame. You had it and you lost all the shine. I can buy a Billy, don't talk to me. For a show 150, don't talk to me. You ain't never helped your mans, don't talk to me. You just follow all the trends, don't talk to me. I set the bar, I'm the bar. Look in the sky, I'm a star. I don't fall in love, cause I be loving. Like my shirt, it's a large. Yeah. I don't care, I crush a ghost. Got two cribs in two states, I be doing the most. I got white folks' money that I won't blow. And if you ask why, cause the white folks don't.
Big bank, tight, low bank. Bank. Big bank, tight, low bank. Bank. The type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need a buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank. Big bank, tight, low bank. Bye.
Everything proper, no propaganda. Chopper counter, go yard bandana. Big, a lot of like Santa. Threw a birthday party on a phantom. Big, like a dinosaur did it. And you know, no channel like acrylic. Yeah, but had cornrows. I can see you hang with the door closed. Now I'm looking for a glove with a sparkle on it. And my got chocolate on it. Big bank, take small. Bank account on some tall. Attitude on some. Bankroll on what it do, boo. He had the rule at 5. And if I ain't did it yet, I'll try.
Big bank, tight, low buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low buy, buy. Type of money you gon' need a sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low bank, buy. Big bank, tight, low buy.
She said, what you gon' do if I leave? I said, I'ma do me. B-I-G, everything zoomed in. Big on me looking like I'm moving in. Got my foot in the door and we still here. I'm a first generation millionaire. I broke the curse of my family not having. I'm passionate like us after more than just cashing. Feed me to the wolves, now I lead the packing. You boys all cap, I'm more Colin Kaepernick. I'm rare as affordable healthcare. Or going to wealth from welfare. I turn my W's to, yeah, I f*** those. I might buy a red bottoms with the crypto. 3 coins, that'll pay your whole semester. But you gotta better than a Tesla.
Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. The type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank, tight, low, buy, buy. Big bank, tight, low, buy.
Back again, back to back, made back, stacked it. I'm a Slim Shady, baby, the M. Once he black, he'll be back again. Tell him that it's crunch time abdomen. Yes, I caught Mad Chanel and Mad Javin. She did it again, imagine them. About to make these bums mad again. Uh-oh. Back to them. I lead the pack, so my back's to them. Yup, the queen's back, what's happening? Rerun, about to make these rap again. Diamond chains on my ankle. Young money in the cut like a tell tip, rubber bands on my bankroll. Show my like a
big bank tight, low buy, buy. Big bank tight, low buy, buy. The type of money you gon' need to sight. The type of money you gon' need to buy. From the hood, this type of money make you stay away. Type of money gon' let you. Big bank tight, low buy, buy. Big bank tight, low buy, buy.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 19 on EA Sports. On tap, we've got what should be a fairly intriguing matchup between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the San Francisco 49ers. With that, let's get you out to Silicon Valley, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, as we welcome in our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
We're about 40 miles south of Candlestick Point as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. A few short moments ago, these two teams made their way out of the Levi's Stadium tunnels, and the noise level in this place was deafening. They're set for football as the 49ers get ready to do battle with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn. Happy to be with you and CD as we get this thing going. Give the folks at home something to keep their eye on.
The running game for both teams, because I think this is going to be an old-fashioned, old-school type of a game. Physical, who wins up front, who runs the ball the best and controls the clock, they will come out the victor.
Josh Lambeau now ready to put this one in the air. And we are underway from Santa Clara. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the 49ers. They'll be led out by their quarterback, standing at 6'2" from Eastern Illinois. It's Jimmy Garoppolo.
Athletic, accurate, strong arm, knows how to make something out of nothing, and is also an excellent leader.
Flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping.
Encroachment, defense.
So a jump there defensively.
And it's a killer. Watch the football.
Still first down.
Don't move across the line of scrimmage until the ball moves.
So this helps to start a drive. After the penalty, it'll be first and 5.
Hey,
From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And he finds his target. It's Marquise Goodwin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 11 yards for number 11.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
Play fake here on first down. And his throw here is incomplete. Pierre Garçon, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41.
Left 80, right 20.
Now the Georgia Southern man, this is Jerick McKinnon. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge.
Now the Georgia Southern man, it's Matt Breida. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up 2nd and 5. Partner, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground. And then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
This is Breida. And oh, he's going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Automatic first down.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a 1st and 10.
Here we go.
Now whistles here, and I think one of the big boys for the 49ers might have jumped.
False start, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. A false start backs him up 5, 1st and 15. They go play action here on 1st down. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterback's got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
So they'll come up after the incompletion for 2nd down.
By 20, by 80.
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And his throw's going to be incomplete. The intended receiver, Marquise Goodwin. And it's third down. That's already the third time they've looked his way on this opening drive. He's caught one of the three.
That doesn't mean they won't continue to go in that direction. It feels like they think they've got something good going there, and they think those numbers are going to increase.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Working from the gun, Garoppolo. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. Robbie Gould on now to try the field goal. From the right hash, this from 48. And Gould is able to put it through. And the 49ers take a 3-0 lead. So an opening drive field goal maybe doesn't whip this crowd into a frenzy, but I think that they will take the early lead.
There's no doubt about it. They will always take the early lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can break things open. But right now, this is all about letting the offense just get settled in.
Punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. So here's the first drive now for the Jags. They'll be led out by their quarterback from Central Florida. It's Blake Bortles.
And you can see why he was the number 3 pick when he came out in the NFL draft. 6'5", sturdy guy, strong arm, led his UCF team to a big bowl victory over Baylor, and runs the ball way better than he's ever given credit for.
Bortles leads the Jags up 1st and 10 at their own 28-yard line. A fake to Fournette. Now it's Bortles to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line.
When we talk about the best corners in the league, we're usually saying shut down corners. Guys, you can't complete passes against. Richard Sherman fits that definition to a T. The best part of his game, no wasted moves. He studies the opponent so well. Hard, hard, hard to get a pass on Richard Sherman.
Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Suddenly, it's 1st and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Garoppolo. This will be caught at about the 6. That'll bring up 2nd and goal after the gain of 5.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
2nd and goal from inside the 5.
Keep it 80!
Looking to throw, Garoppolo. To the sideline, wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds. Only able to pick up two, and that leads us to third and goal. Great footwork there, Charles, to dot the I's, stay in bounds, get both feet in. He's probably thinking, though, man, I made a catch like that close to the end zone, I should have scored.
Yeah, there's always a regret when you're that close to the goal line. But let's go back to what you talked about before, getting his feet down. Would you say dotting the I? I can cross the T as well. That was excellent footwork to get in bounds and make a great catch.
They'll try and run with McKinnon. Oh, and they had it stopped short of the first, but a penalty marker down. And that looked like a clear face mask to me.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
So instead of forcing the field goal, it'll be first and goal.
Yeah, the force was trying to make something happen that just didn't need to, right? I mean, the plays happen, let it go. It's over. Instead, it creates a penalty.
So the ball's moved to about the one after the penalty, first and goal. They'll try to run with Breida. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Back at the two now, here's second and goal. Throwing now is Garoppolo. The chalk into the end zone. It's a 49er touchdown. In for the score. And the 49ers add six to their lead.
A good tight end is a heck of a weapon for any quarterback, especially when you're able to create some mismatches. Sometimes they work against a linebacker, sometimes they work against a smaller defensive back. But when they find it, they go to it, and it often results in touchdowns.
Robbie Gould on for the extra point. Extra point, and the lead grows to 10-0. A drive there of just four plays, and the end result for the 49ers, a touchdown. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. And last time, one play interception, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Bortles leads the Jags up first and 10 at their own 24. Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And the offensive unit now for the Jaguars.
Let's take a look at tight end Austin Seferian Jenkins, or ASJ, as his friends and all announcers like to call him because it's a whole lot easier. Second tight end drafted in 2014, but production was really lacking until 2017 with the New York Jets.
at 50 catches, which was more in his two-plus combined years with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10.
Green 80. Green 80.
Now a first carry for T.J. Yeldon. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring him down. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
Look, the first down marker is out there, but sometimes it's hard to find for an offense when they're in a long yardage situation, which usually means throw the football. In this case, they went against the tendency and ran it, and boy, the reward was there. A big, big pickup, and guess what? It's now third and very short in order to try and pick up a first down.
Going to try and throw on third down, and that is incomplete.
And third down is a key down in any game you play, and third down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good first step right there.
And the Jaguars send out their punter. Back deep, Trent Taylor. And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offense coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Garoppolo going to bring the Niners up here first and 10 at the 20. Here's Garoppolo on first and 10. And an alley to run. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
So first and 10 now from the 30. On play action, it's Garoppolo. Got his target, Pierre Garçon. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Here we go. By 20.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take this across midfield into Jacksonville territory. A gain of 3, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now Garoppolo throwing on second. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. Garoppolo to his tight end Kittle for a Niner first down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Garoppolo now, 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here.
By 20.
can get settled in here. Time expires. On the first quarter of action. 10-zip our score. We're back to Santa Clara after this.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. To throw, Garoppolo. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out, incomplete.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion. Kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Garoppolo again here on second and 10. Wide open receiver complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Garoppolo to Goodwin there for a 49er first.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage. And that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Again, zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you make curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. Garoppolo on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll make it a second down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit, but get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are, you know, make someone miss in the open field.
Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? Defense. So step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know. Defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that one.
And they've got another first and 10 as the penalty keeps this drive moving. Here's Breida. The great move couldn't free him. Taken down at the 10. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Second down, here's Garoppolo. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to lead to a third and 11.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Under 4 to play now. Clock running, third down. Garoppolo looks to throw. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked by Ronnie Harrison. And now running right through it. And he'll be brought down at his own 10-yard line. Well, we have a second, Charles. The Patriots, of course, back in the Super Bowl, getting the 37-31 victory over KC in the AFC title game. Great game, but you know, the Patriots...
nobody believes in them.
Yeah, right.
You
they're playing that underdog card, but I thought it was funny because after the game, they asked Tom Brady, were you guys just trying to use that for your own motivation? He said no comment because they were. They know they're not the underdog.
They know it, but when you've been that great for this long,
you need something.
You've got to find something different. And Tom Brady, I've got to give him credit. Somehow he made his team buy that and believe in it when no one else in the country did. And I think it really started with their first playoff game this year when the Chargers came to town. I know I picked the Chargers against them. A lot of people picked the Chargers. They took that as, well, no one believes in us, and everyone thinks we're not as good. They were just wrong about that part, as we were wrong about the Chargers beating them.
Bortles leads the Jags up first and 10 from back at their own 10-yard line.
Green 80! Green 80!
They'll start out on the ground. It's T.J. Yeldon. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Whether it's what we call an even front or an odd front, and an odd front's real easy to figure out. If that guy is lined up over the nose of the center, typically that's an odd front defense, odd number of people, meaning 3-4 versus the 4-3, which is an even front. You've got to control those guys in the middle. Whether it's the nose or the two defensive tackles in a four-man front, if those guys can't get moved, you cannot run the ball in the middle of the field. And in that play, they were able to actually take care of business.
They keep it with Yeldon on first down. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Throw on 2nd down. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now 3rd down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better. Got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They've got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3.
Green 80! Green 80!
Shotgun now for Bortles. And the Niners get there and bring him down.
Got to give him points for the attempt, but there's just a wave of pressure there. A host of people in the area. Evades a few, but couldn't evade all of them.
And the Jaguars send out their punter as he's on to kick it away. This is brought in at the 21. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Niners will go on offense. 1st and 10. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. It's a 2nd quarter. His team has the lead, but I think he's hoping for a little bit more production out of himself.
And we often talk about preaching patience to a runner when things are a little bumpy in the early going, but we have to do the same thing with the offensive line. They can't wait to halftime to make the adjustments. They have to do it from series to series. So those surface tablets come into play. Check out what the defense is doing and see if they can find a better way to run it.
So they search for that patience here now. The drive starts with a handoff to McKinnon. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. 1:59 to go in the first half. Back to more NFL action on EA Sports after this. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. Garoppolo to throw on second down. The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And they work this well upfield across the 45. A good pick up there of 20 yards.
Well, from an offense's perspective, that sure was pretty, because the corner route, it's extremely difficult to defend from my perspective.
What we just saw there, is that sort of the evolution of the tight end position?
Yeah, I think it is, because more and more, tight ends are being treated like wide receivers. These are some agile players who can make a play in any spot on the field.
Garoppolo, 10 of 16, throwing the football. It's first and 10.
Left 80! Left 80!
To throw, it's Garoppolo. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. But with that incompletion, let's look back, Charles, to the NFC title game. We had two excellent conference championship games, but on the NFC side, the Rams winning in overtime thanks to Greg Zuerlein. He had two huge kicks, but that was really overshadowed because afterwards, obviously, everyone talking about the no call.
Yeah, and we should be talking about Legatron, a 48-yarder to get them to overtime. The 57-yarder to win it in overtime. He should be the guy who should be exalted right now, but you're exactly right. Nickell Robey Coleman's hit on Tommy Lee Lewis in regulation, when I saw it live, thought it was a bang-bang play. Turned out, it was definitely a missed call. Plus, they missed helmet-to-helmet contact on it as well. So if you're a Saints fan, you are very unexcited about the Rams advancing to the Super Bowl, but I still don't want pass interference to become a reviewable call. The game flow is paramount to me. Let's not slow it down any more than it already is.
Yeah, it could be a slippery slope, then you start doing it with everything. Right. And oh, it caught it up! And did the Jaguars come up with it? They did! Often on fumbles, you look at the guy who coughed it up and say, geez, what did he do? But hey, let's tip the cap to the defense here.
Not a problem at all, my man. I'm not even going to tip it. I'm going to doff my cap to him. Congratulations. Big-time play. Knocking it free and creating something good for your team.
Here comes Blake Bortles now to lead his offense back out there. He's got to dig deep here, doesn't he? Team's losing. He's not playing well either.
And they always tell you, don't press. You'll make things a little bit worse. But in this particular situation, you try and heighten your play a little bit. So far, he's thrown one interception. He wants to balance that off with at least one touchdown pass in order to get his team back moving forward.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. Now before this second down play, we'll get whistles and a timeout, as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. And welcome back. The offensive unit, they took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. Throwing on second down, and Austin Seferian Jenkins has it. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. First down is Bortles. And the catch made here by Marquise Lee. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. A gain of 6 there on first.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who could turn it loose. And, boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4.
380.
Working from the gun, it's Bortles. This is Yeldon on the dump off. And offensively, they'll take the timeout with 6 seconds left in the second quarter. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get 3 before half. This from 54 yards away. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This is taken at the 3. So we've hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers out in front. As we'll send you back over to Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report, here's Jonathan Coachman.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is taken at the 3. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Now a play fake here on first down. That is incomplete. Well, the upcoming Super Bowl, so many storylines, but one that obviously grabs you. Sean McVay just turned 33 January 24th, youngest coach ever to take a team to the Super Bowl. Double that age for Bill Belichick, who's 66. And, Charles, that's the largest gap between coaches in Super Bowl history.
Yeah, and when you think about it, obviously the age comes into play, but to me it's more the experience. the number of times that the Patriots have gone to the Super Bowl with Belichick leading them versus Sean McVay's first time in the Super Bowl leading the Rams. Will that game experience come into play at all? But I do like this about Sean McVay. Raised in the game, raised up through the NFL system, no matter how young he might be. Remember, his grandfather was a head coach and a GM in the league. He gets it. He understands. I highly expect the moment to be just fine for him and not too big.
So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, second and 15. After the penalty, it's Fournette. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards will get him back to the original line of scrimmage, but now they're looking at third and 10.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Cassius Marsh in there to get him for a loss of three, and it'll be fourth down. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
And the Jaguars send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
And he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line.
I think we can safely say that those types of plays are the backbone of this offense. We know not every run's going to be a big hitter, but you know they'll take that type of result on each and every attempt.
They run again with Breida. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. Telvin Smith that time there to make the play. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Garoppolo going to try and throw on third. And able to haul it in is Kittle. And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35. The gain of four that time as the drive continues.
At first glance, I thought he just used his size in order to win the route. But he also had a little subtle move in there as well. Made the defender think he was going one direction and was able to track the ball in another.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
They run with Breida, and he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Miles Jack there to make the tackle.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
The Niners on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? They looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box there.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10.
Four down. Here we go.
They go play action here on first down. Sideline throw. It's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch.
Now McKinnon. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. Breida, and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Tackle that time by Ronnie Harrison.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. 5 yards on the play there. It's a drive will continue.
I know flashy plays, as people like to call them, that attracts a lot of attention. But let's face it, when you're efficient, that can control a ball game. And I love the game plan they've got going right now.
Back-to-back 5-yard gains. Didn't force the ball downfield. Picked it up on the ground.
Yeah, offensive line, they're getting it done.
First is Garoppolo. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
So now they'll come up on 2nd and 10, once again from the 28.
Four down.
They run it with McKinnon. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a 3rd down.
Part of the thinking when you bring in extra tight ends, you're hoping that each of your guys gets those one-on-one blocks and creates a crease for your runner. You know what the converse is, though? You've got to win those one-on-one blocks. And when you don't, that's the result you end up with.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here in Santa Clara. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter. The Niners on third down. They've hit it 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and 11.
180!
A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And Gold is able to put it through, and they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make them score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But, hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
Green 80. Green 80.
On first and 10, here's Bortles. Looking long for Westbrook. And that's caught inside the 30. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21. Now, they've been struggling in the passing game. Do you like the aggressiveness there? I mean, it worked on that play, but do you like it?
I do, because a lot of the time you're struggling because your passing lanes are clogged. That usually happens when you're throwing the ball underneath. People start to press up on you. Push them deep. Find some space and open things up again. Being aggressive there, I think, will pay off for them.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone.
Green 80! Green 80!
Bortles now on first down. And that's incomplete.
But plain and simple, that's the second time today that he's dropped a pass.
And that one, I think, maybe even a little easier than the earlier one that he dropped. Surprising.
Was this game announced as a night game prior to, and maybe his rhythm is just off? He's got thrown off. He's going to have to wake up, enjoy the sunshine, and go play.
From the 21, it's second and 10. Back to the air on second down. It's Bortles. Seferian Jenkins has it. And they'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much since. Bortles to throw once more. And incomplete here on third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. And Lambeau will put this one through, and they will cut the lead back down to a touchdown now at 13-6. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
Now after the made field goal, back out Lambeau to kick this one off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. There are the 49ers getting set to trot out there. The field goal we just saw has us now at a one-score game, and on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? It might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball, but here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that, and that means opening things up again, being a little more free in what they're trying to get done on offense.
On first down, Garoppolo firing quickly here, and that's complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Offensively, with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
Well, they didn't accomplish their goal. They didn't get a stop there, gave up another first down. They have all 3 timeouts in their pocket. I think defensively, you've got to start thinking about using them here.
I was just going to ask you at what point you think now's the go time?
I think now's the go time. I don't think you sit back and wait because they can take a lot of time off the clock between plays and run 3 to 4 and really put you in a stressful spot.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. And on the ground they go with a running back. DJ Hayden, the corner, in on the tackle. Now, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Wow, a personal foul at this stage in the fourth.
Automatic
hard
first
to believe.
Down.
Really hard to believe, and now that glow of hope that you had begins to flicker out, doesn't it?
Yep. So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, 1st and 10. Now a toss play. It's Breedum. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. So fresh out of the 2-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field. I have to imagine this will be on the ground as well as they come up 2nd and 7. Garoppolo looking to throw. The quick slant caught. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Marquise Goodwin from 10 yards out. And the 49ers add on to their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a 2-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Gold able to tack on the extra point, and the lead now up to 14. So the drive there took 6 plays, and it's polished off by a touchdown for San Francisco. The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And now out come the Jags. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder and puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. Bortles now on 1st down. Left side complete, Safarian Jenkins. And this one will go to the 28-yard line.
The completion good for three, and it's second down. On second down, here's Bortles. His throw incomplete. The intended target, the tight end, Austin Seferian Jenkins. And it's third down.
I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
And that one could very easily have been intercepted. And if it does get picked off, that could possibly seal this one.
The Jaguars on third down. Not good. 0 for 4 thus far. This is third and 7.
380.
Bortles gives to Yeldon on the draw. And he'll be brought down, but a tip of the cap on the spin move, as that gives him a first down. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. On first down, Bortles. He goes underneath for Yeldon. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center eligible stuff, but still a lot of guys to account for.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. From the gun, it's Bortles. That's into the hands of Westbrook over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. Here's Bortles to throw. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Lee. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's another 10 yards on that one, and another first down. Again, it's Bortles. A throw left side complete to his receiver, Westbrook. Gave a glimpse of his quick feet and then taken down right at the 30.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag. But you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
The penalty moves him into the red zone here on first and 10. Into the red zone, it's Bortles. And this is going to be incomplete. T.J. Yeldon, the one he was looking for. And it's second down.
Certainly looked like maybe his third or his fourth read on his progression. Just trying to find his outlet man that time. Ends up leading him just a bit too much.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Now Bortles again. And he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he's sacked. Cassius Marsh in there to drop him as the clock continues to roll. On third and long, it's Bortles. And all the way to the 2-yard line there before crossing over out of bounds. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Shotgun now for Bortles. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard.
Bortles to throw on second down. And he will go down outside of the pocket for a sack. Tried to get away but could not. Malcolm Smith in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal. Win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.